Menace, have you been working out?
Yeah, man, like this.
Oh, jeez, you pooped on my face! Oh, no! What are we doing? Ladder's tough.
That's huge. We'll go right to the top and jump.
This is gonna be fun! It's getting nighttime.
It looks like it never ends.
It doesn't ever end. This is gonna be a long intro.
Speed it up.
Whoa, there goes the moon!
That moon is cruising.
It
is. How fast is it going?
It'll stop when it hits the horizon. Man, this is really high off the ground. And the walking sound makes the... Oh, are we done?
I'm going.
What?
Is it? This is the top.
This is the top.
Banania!
Oh, there he goes. Oh, I can't see. I'm going. Woo! When do I open my shoe? Oh!
Press the button.
Hey there, everybody. Mazion reporting for duty, and today is ARK episode 10. Man, today's been rough. I'm going to tell you what. Please bear with me. I woke up this morning, and I had to go to the emergency room, and I was in great pain. Apparently, I've got a kidney stone, and I got to tell you, don't ever get one of those. It is rough, but I'm on like 5 different kind of medications or something. I'm a little bit woozy, but I want to make sure that I get a video out to you guys every day right now, so I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to go out and do my thing. But so today, what I'm going to try to do is, I'm not going to go out for a specific kind of dino, but I do need so many different kinds. I need a high-level mammoth, I need a high-level saber, I need a high-level rex, I need a high-level spino. So we're just going to kind of go out today and see what we can get. We're going to go get on our Argentavis razor wing face, and we're going to have a go at whatever we can find. We're going to probably go inland along the river where you can find the most diverse set of dinos and see what we can do. So without further ado, we're going to go upstairs, we're going to get on Razor Wing Face, we're going to go try to find us something, anything, to tame today. So I'll be doing that right now, and we'll see you guys in a minute. So I just kind of wanted to go over how my circuit here works when I'm trying to look for new dinos. Now you see, I'm right next to this one mountain, and any woolly mammoths might be up here for us to tame. There are also sabers up on this mountain. And directly south of where I'm located, you see here, there's a long river. Now, that river area is really ripe with a ton of wildlife. So when I go down there, I'm always looking for spinos and, well, it used to be pteranodons. I'm not really concerned about that anymore. But also go look for rexes and scorpions on these mountains, actually. But the rexes are at the river, of course. So that's kind of what I do, and then on the upper right-hand corner, that's Death Island. And if all else fails, I end up going out that way. So I just kind of wanted to go over that so you guys had a good idea of where to get things. You can get good RGs and woolies and sabers and scorpions on these mountains. So if you're ever looking for high-level stuff in that category, you can go there. And then spinos and some other things down by this river here, pretty much anything. And then out on the island, of course, you get RGs and spinos. No spinos out there. I've never seen one before. Also, scorpions out there as well. So I'm going to go and have a look in this area. Now, we saw a woolly mammoth up on this ridge over here. Now, there's one right there. Have a look at it. I've always wanted one of these big black guys. They look really, really cool. That one's only level 6. So I'm going to look around for something in these areas. And if I find something, I'll be right back with you folks. Oh, right. Well, we made a great find. We found a level 112 black mammoth. It looks really awesome. It's over here in this area. It looks like I could get up on top of that rock there and maybe try to tame it. But there's also a lot of other baddies around here, as you can see. Pardon me. So it might be kind of a challenge. But what we're going to do is we're going to clean this area out a little bit. We're going to come take out some of these guys that are dueling each other. And we're going to remember that berries are the key to the... Key to the soul of these guys. Make sure that we get enough berries. I'm not sure where we're gonna get berries from up here. It doesn't look like there's much, so we're gonna have to go get some berries ahead of time. Remember where this guy's at, and come back for him. But I don't think something tells me he's not gonna. Oh, there's a T-Rex. 36. Go get rid of that level 36 T-Rex so it doesn't wander over and try to eat our mammoth's face. And yeah, so I'm going to go get some preemptive berries, make sure that we have stuff on for the mammoth, and then we're going to be right back with you guys. Talon! So I quickly realized that around the area where the mammoth is, there's really no plants for me to gather medjool berries. So I came back to the base and I took note of where that area was on the map. Now, I didn't make a marker, but it's that second mountain between us and the river there. So I came back, I got some medjool berries on Dozer. Now, Dozer doesn't have them on him right now. I put them on Razorwing Face. And I want to make a mention here that I think that one of the best plans to do is, see, I've got myself a preserving bin, I've got myself a mortar, and I've got myself a thatch foundation along with some spark powder. And I made that as like a kit so that when I get out there, I don't have to make these things. But I did not think about getting medjool berries. I think it's a good idea that whenever you're going out hunting and you're trying to get yourself something to tame, make sure that you have this set up on your animal so that you will be able to not have to worry about this, be able to tame whatever you want, and be all set. So I'm going to get back on Razorwing Face. We're going to go back towards that mountain, and hopefully that guy hasn't moved on us. So we've come back up on our mammoth here, and he's being attacked, and I'm not sure how much these sabers are going to really hurt him. So we're going to give him a hand here, take care of these sabers, and make sure that he's going to be able to be tamed by us. These carnivores are trying to kill him hard. Ah, man. Oh no, the mammoth died. Well, that's what we get for not coming prepared. So, gonna go back out and try to find something else. Man, that's a really, really sad. That was a really cool looking mammoth. But that, you know, that teaches you that when you're going out to get yourself something, make sure you're prepared. If you're not prepared, then you'll come back and there'll be a bunch of sabers and stuff attacking your mammoth, and then you'll have to find something new. So, gotta move on. All right, so found ourselves another mammoth here. It's only level 96, but I mean 96 is pretty high, considering the low level of all of my dinos. I think it's a good find, and I've gone ahead and culled the area, killed everything that I think that was going to be a problem over here, and gone ahead and got it ready for taming. Now I don't want anything to come up and attack it while we have it dead, so I'm going to make a kind of a wide loop around here and make sure all the stuff has been taken care of. So that's gone. We got that saber out of the way. I've never really come out to an area that was so dangerous and tried to tame something. So we're going to get off of our RG here. I think that we're pretty safe to start trying to tame this guy. So they're not all that fast. I'm going to set Razorwing Face down right here. I'm going to make sure that I put them on passive so that we don't have any problems. See, stop moving, Razorwing Face. Make sure we got him on passive. Come on. All right, he's on passive. And that big boy should be right after us. Hopefully he doesn't go after the RG. There we go. No, don't attack the RG. No, no. You can't be doing that, man. That's not okay. Not okay. You be safe over here, Razorwing Face. Shoot him in the face. Make sure that we wait the appropriate amount of time in between. In the past, you've been a little bit too zealous. This guy's pretty fast. I want to tame you, sir. Not be killed by you. See if we can get it stuck somewhere. These guys walk right over the rocks, so we might not have any good luck trying to get him stuck. And now I'm not really sure whether or not to use the crossbow. I'm going to give it a shot because it doesn't have to wind up. You can just pew pew. And we're going to watch his body to see if we get him a little bit too hurt while we're doing this. Keep going. Can't sprint while you're reloading your crossbow. Oh, there's your dead wife. Oh, I'm so sorry. I mean, I just needed to make sure they didn't attack me, man. You know? Okay. He looks like he's getting a little hurt. We're going to start shooting him in the body instead of the face. We shoot him in the leg. Oh! Do this. Okay. Getting a little bloody. I'm going to go back to using the regular bow and just rely on the trank to bring the torpor down. Right. I think I hit him in the face again. I'm starving. Not a good time to be starving. This guy's going to come get me. All right, run away. Eat some food. All right. Man, guys, aggressive. I don't want to shoot him in the face anymore. Ow! Oh, look, my new ramshackle armor is pretty rugged. Oh. Give it some time in between. Try not to kill this bad boy. Come on, you falling asleep? Oh, you stuck? Are you stuck? No, that's too bad. How are we gonna get this guy stuck? Maybe we can find some trees. Maybe he'll get stuck between this tree and this rock. See if we can do that. Come here, mammoth, 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 mammoth. I don't know. Looks like it's pretty wide. Are you stuck? Are you stuck? Uh-oh. I think we got him stuck. I shoot him in the foot. I don't see any other predators around here right now. Perfect. So we could find a way to get this guy stuck. All right. Wait a good amount of time in between each shot. Hopefully we don't kill him. He's getting real bloody. You know, I wish I had my slingshot with me. I'd try knocking him out in the face with a slingshot. Wish I had one of those nice ramshackle slingshots. He's not liking his front feet right now. Still kind of safe here, looks like. Bam! Man, it's gonna take a lot of arrows to get this boy down. He's, looking really, really hurt. This is our taming song. Okay. Now I'm really, really worried that there's going to be something else in the area that comes up and eats this guy once we've got him out. Is that it? Is that it? Is he knocked out or dead? He's unconscious. Alright, we gotta go get Razor Wing Face and get some Medjoo Berries. Start taming this guy. I'm also gonna look around the area, continue to make sure that it's clear. And we'll be right back with you. Now, I was just thinking that I might kill these corpses that I've left around here in order to stop attracting other kinds of dinos. But the more I thought about it, I was like, you know what? Me and Razorwing Face can take out pretty much anything. So if I leave those, then they're going to be a deterrent for any animals to come over and get our currently being tamed mammoth. So I'm going to leave those up. I'm going to keep looking around, see if I can find anything that's going to stop our tame and mess up our progress. But right now, it looks like this area is pretty clear. So it looks like we're in good shape. The mammoth tame, though, oh man, it seems like it's like that Bronto we had the other day. It took hours to tame, and looks like we're going to be in the same boat with this guy. So we're going to be around for a while. I've got 400 Medjoo Berries on him. Not really sure exactly how much it's going to take to get the tame done. But with any luck, we won't have much more problems. Looks like we'll get plus 47 levels out of this guy. So it's going to be a 140... 143, something like that. Yep, 143 should be, and yeah, we'll see you soon. All right, guys. So we're about to have a tamed mammoth. Now it's next feeding. It's going to be tamed, so it'll be pretty soon here. And a couple things that I wanted to mention. You see, I built this big enclosure around him, and the reason why I have gone and done that is because I was worried that he might be attacked. And you know, I'm not sure how exactly effective that this is, but I do know that at my base, three tall wall structures are making it so that things don't see my dinos on the inside. So I was hoping that that would be helpful. Now, another couple of tips that I wanted to give out there is that when you are here and when you're out taming, if you get on your bird, your food and water will diminish less, because if you're running around on your character, you're going to be using your stamina, you're going to be using your food, you're going to be using your water. The other thing is that I built a couple of fires on the outside. It was really cold up here, and so I think that that's a good thing too. If you also need some extra meat while you're up here, that's going to be helpful as well. Now, Menace was awesome and came out here and brought a saddle because I didn't know I was going to tame today, so I didn't bring one. But Menace was close, and he came over and gave a saddle. And what's up, Menace? How's it going, man?
Hey, I'm good, thanks, man. There's your tame. Congratulations.
Oh, woo! He's trying to follow you.
He's following me.
He's your tame. What's up with that?
So, another tip as well is that if you put the saddle on the mammoth while he's knocked out, he'll actually gain the extra armor that the saddle provides. So, if he does get attacked, it will survive a bit longer.
Yeah, that's great. Definitely helpful. I really appreciate you bringing that out because as I bring it back, I mean, it's so far away from my compound. I'm going to have to lead him all the way there, and I'm going to have to protect him and whatnot. So, it was really cool for you to bring him out. Let's go check out his stats!
What do you man.
Got, Mammoth? 603 weight, that's a good start. And
so many food.
So many, yeah, see, man, lately on all my tames, the food stat's been getting pumped the most from the tame, and it's really, really annoying. Like, it's the least important stat, you know what I mean? You always keep food on him, not like he's gonna die.
True, but I mean, at least you will have to a little bit less upkeep. I mean, not much.
Right. Well, thank you very much again for coming out and helping out with that saddle. That's going to be a big help as I try to move this guy all the way back. It's going to be a pain to get him all the way there. I got to take some time and demolish this structure because I'm not sure what spawns around here, and I want to make sure that we aren't doing anything we shouldn't be doing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. Because the obsidian around here that I just mined actually won't respawn because of this structure. So, yeah, probably better off ripping it all down.
Exactly.
Do you want your bird, or would you like me to take it back now?
No, actually, I was thinking that it would be safer if I rode my bird so that I can protect my mammoth. My mammoth will follow me, you know what I mean? So I'll just keep him safe with the bird. That'll probably be the best bet. But again, thank you very much for coming out and bringing that saddle. It was a huge help. That'll definitely make it easier to protect him as we're going on.
Yeah, no worries, man. Good luck on your trip, and make sure you pay me that 1,000 spark powder interest when you give me the saddle back.
Oh, no problem, man. I got that brewing already for you. I anticipated that you were going to be helpful again, and then, you know, got that going
helpful.
For you.
In inverted, yeah. All right, mate. See you later.
Take it easy, man. Thank you. Oh, right. It was a long, long road. I ended up going the wrong way around the mountain to the right, so it would have been a much shorter trip if I had gone around the mountains to the left. Ended up going around to the right, but here we are, back at the house. We've got our new mammoth. We got to go name that guy. I forgot to name him when we were out there. But we're going to get him in the door. Got to name him. What's the giraffe doing? Like there must have been... Looks like they're after something that's in the water. Let's go see what's going on. Let's go see. Man. Everybody's up in here doing things. Frank's in my building. Yours under my building. What happened, guys? Fiora! Everybody's out here doing something. I'm guessing it's a megalodon somewhere. Oh yeah, there's a dead megalodon. level 12. Man, I gotta fix their fix what their call is. It's definitely not good that they're that the Bronto and everything we're all going over there to the water to kill the Megalodon. All right. So we've got our new mammoth. I can't tell him to stop following Razorwing Face. Getting dark. Brighten things up around here. Oh look, it's daytime again. Wonderful. So we've got our new mammoth. He's already gained some levels because we had to kill some stuff on the way back. We're gonna pump all of his levels into weight because I'm gonna be using him as a resource hog. Gonna give this guy a name. Change name. E. Not go with E. All right. So we've got Dozer. And I think we're gonna name this guy something different than a equipment piece. I'm gonna call him Stompy. Stompy the Mammoth. Got Stompy the Mammoth now. He's got a saddle thanks to Menace. And now we've got two Mammoth to go gather stuff with. And they're mate boosted! Look at that! Mate boosted. Got the right gender and everything. Alright, so we're back at the base now. We've named our mammoth, and he's level 128. We got a new guy. Just want to go over a couple of the tips that we talked about today. If you're out on your Argentavis doing your taming, you can stay on its back in the air, and that will avoid the usage of food and water as much on your main character. It's always best to bring a saddle with you if you can. You know what you're going to be taming, so that when you're trying to get back home, it has some more armor. Make sure you have some fires where you're at so that you can cook yourself some food and keep yourself warm, because I had to do that while I was out there. I was getting really cold. That was the first reason why I actually built the fire. You can build a wall around your tamed animal or the animal that you are taming so that you can avoid line of sight with predators. And apparently there is a food that you can make with eggs called kibble. And that's the maximum taming effectiveness food that you can use for animals like mammoths or any other berry-eating animal. And that's something that I'm going to look into. I looked up on the website what to feed the mammoth, and manjo berry seemed to be the top. But apparently there's a really good taming food called kibble that you can use. I want to give a shout-out again to Menace. That guy's very helpful. Came out, gave me a saddle because I didn't know what I was going to tame. Ended up taming this. Been very helpful to me, and I appreciate him very much. Oh, now considering the way this morning went with the massive kidney pains, I mean, it's been a good day. Been able to get some stuff done. Sorry for the shorter video. I usually will do a little bit longer than this, but I mean, it's been a rough one, guys. But thank you very much. If you have anything to say, please comment down below, like and subscribe, and as always, be excellent to each other.